I have some auditor out. Some cherries and berries rolling. Saturday night. Right around midnight, ain't it? Huh?
Hot Saturday night.
A little humid, ain't it?
Yeah.
Right around midnight on, I guess it would be Sunday morning, actually. It's after midnight.
First video of the night.
Looks like it's a little cracked up in the back. I believe. It's one of the Blankenships. Unbearded.
Yes, Brandon. You got me down.
Was the driver still in the vehicle? Did you notice? Or did you notice? I didn't either. That's why I was asking.
Car, huh?
It's like it took a hit in the back end.
Yeah.
Looks like it definitely took a hit. Having fun yet? I assume that's in the car with him. We'll stay off of that one.
Yeah.
So, apparently there's one in custody.
Yeah.
Don't know.
One is in custody.
It's the only problem with rolling up after everything's over. Yeah. Hell, you never know what happened. Or why, for that matter.
That feel like we were just headed
about to head to the house.
Yeah. We did get out of this day a little bit long. Got seriously bleed there for a long time. It did. We wasn't doing nothing anymore.
Yeah, it's hard to catch you side streets if you're not, you know.
This is the first time we were videoed on this one.
First time we've definitely been on this street with cameras rolling. Corner of what, like 10th and Pine?
Yeah.
Yes. 10th and Pine.
Yeah, 10th and Pine.
Dog barking.
Oh, I thought that was the dog. I thought one of them had jumped off.
No, Nah, that definitely ain't Ike. He won't shut up.
Yeah, Ike never shuts up.
Nah, Ike makes way too much, makes a lot more noise than that. Especially when we get around. He absolutely hates us getting near the vehicle. Yeah.
You think about now, he'd be used to us in some way, anyway.
Well, he's never met us. Not officially. I don't even know if they can see out the windows from inside. I have no idea. They just hear us. Those that don't know, this is Sgt McKnight and Patrolman Blankenship in that vehicle there. The humidity is terrible tonight, isn't it?
It is. Yeah. That rain just made it hotter.
Seemed to, didn't it?
Yeah.
Raised the humidity another 20 points. Air so humid you gotta cut it in pieces just to breathe it. Must be switching it up on us. These are two we usually don't see on Friday night much. Or right. Saturday night, I mean.
Yeah.
Keeping us guessing.
Probably. Either keeping us guessing or it could be where Goob got hurt too, though. He's daytime.
Yeah, well, I'm sure they have to roll people around now. They only got like, what, 15? Well, 16 maybe.
16
they,
now, I think.
They tore in a new one.
That Allison?
I believe that's it. Not Allison. Patrolman Allison.
I started saying, don't hold me to it. I'd have to ask one of these guys. But
I believe that was his name. Sergeant
McKnight. Oh, yeah?
I never did make it back in for a full shift, but I did ride with him a couple hours one evening. I think there was one pullover, I think, while I was riding with him.
If I'm not mistaken,
he just warned her about her license plate light. I showed her what it was out.
That's good. Just gave her a warning.
No, I've not rode with
Patrolman McKnight.
This particular Blankenship. I did ride with the other one for a couple hours one night, but nothing happened while we were. It was the night I rode with Sergeant Paul Jerry.
Oh, okay.
He had to go to the Sheriff's Department to do some paperwork on one that K-9 Officer Akers had arrested. So he let me out when I climbed in with the bearded Blankenship and rode with him for a couple hours until the ship was over.
Copy 92.
You know how it is in this town, most things are pretty uneventful.
Well, a lot of people don't realize how small Ironton really is.
Yeah, there really isn't a whole lot going down here.
Probably
looking for that dog. Keeps a burger. A couple of these are some nice looking vehicles, aren't they?
Yeah.
Keep them clean and pretty, don't they?
Yep. Look, even the the people driving them treat one stop and watch them.
Well, it's funny, nobody wants to be stopped by the police, but everybody wants to stop to see what they're doing.
Right. Well, of course, you know. Most of us don't ever get pulled over because we don't go out here and do stupid shit.
Typically.
And really, you don't have, I mean, just turn signal violations, most of them. Obstruction of the plates. So I'll take that back. It would be stupid shit.
This is Ironton. We usually don't have like a lot of hardened criminal activity going on.
what they call hood here. It goes for like what, three blocks?
I guess.
I don't even think it's even three blocks.
I don't know. You live in here, man. You'd know I don't. I live out there, so.
Right.
So I guess it's kind of a catch and release there, huh?
Yep.
Like going fishing.
He did get released.
Like going fishing.
Nope.
He's going to take off there. He didn't want to talk to the camera.
No.
Can't blame him. I probably wouldn't either if I'd just been pulled over.
People want to talk to this camera. Sergeants.
We're some of the few that don't mind.
Right, right. Well, I mean, so far the, you know, police ain't mine.
Well, they're the stars of the show.
Right.
So to speak.
I think it's the only second pool I've ever been on when McKnight's been.
I've been on a couple calls that I couldn't, you know.
Not Brandon. I've gotten Brandon a lot. Sergeant,
mind
telling us about that? Mind telling us about that pool over a little bit?
Exactly.
You
can't say
buff
about right now.
Do
what? So it's. I ain't gonna tell us nothing. It's an active, he says, so. I guess we ain't gonna hear about that, but it looks like they're taking off down the street to go elsewhere. So. Not sure where he's going to now. We'll see if we can figure it out. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. So when we see it, you guys will too. So apparently they are definitely headed somewhere else, so. Guys, if we can catch up to them and see what they're seeing, we'll let you know. But for the moment, Irons and Auditor out, and we'll catch you on the next one.